Hey there, I am here with Adam Montiel of Q104.5, Up and Adam in the Morning.
What's up, Annie B?
Nothing. And we're right here in front of Albino Minari. They're doing their grand opening tasting room right here in downtown Paso. And
Not slow.
As you can see, we got Adam's sweet ride right here.
Oh yeah, I drive the Hearst.
It's the suburban Hearst. I love it.
I don't think it's a suburban.
I don't know what it is.
I don't know.
It's
That's
sweet,
a cool
though.
Ride though. Okay, back
we're
over
gonna
there.
We're gonna roll around the park in it here shortly.
Yeah.
Whatever. On the grass.
we're gonna peel out with wine.
Anyway, so we are thoroughly enjoying this tasting room. They're obviously right here across from the park. They've got a great lineup of wines, two different labels. They've got their Red Rover and their Albino Minari label. The Red Rover is kind of their maybe distribution label, but I think most of their wines go for about $10 a bottle-ish right in there. Great price point. And then the Albino Minari label is, you know,
I think the highest one was 22.
Yeah, so anyway. And you're hanging out in front.
Yeah, grand opening. We got to do the ribbon cutting. Check it out.
Yeah. Got the setup.
Yeah.
So what do you think of the wine so far, Adam?
The wine's so far so good. I tried the Pinot Noir, decked the Pinot Noir. Tempranillo was all right. The Barbera was good. The Cab was good.
Yeah.
And I have yet to go Red Rover, but that's the one I hear everyone talks about.
Well, that's what's funny, too. The Red Rover has a Barbera, and the Albino Minari has a Barbera.
Yeah, so it's a blend? Is that what you're saying?
No, Barbera is a varietal, but it's
they each have...
Yeah, so both labels have both varietals kind of thing.
Yeah, which most people that have two labels won't necessarily have both labels carry the same varietal.
So we're not really sure what the story is on that, but maybe we'll get
We'll find it. We'd like to interview Neil.
Neil or Rocky, right.
Yeah.
And I learned that that varietal, it's pronounced Aberino. Aberino, right.
Yeah, it's not Al.
You don't pronounce the L.
Al.
And you don't say Albarino.
Yeah.
Or right, or albino. Say, hey, can I get some of that albino?
Let me get some of that albino over here. That's not good.
No. Some Bigner.
Yeah, give me some Bigner.
Well, no. Well, I walked in there and I was like, oh, here's Cabernet. Some Albarino. And he was like, oh, no.
Right, no. I just learned that with Rocky. I did 2.5 hours with Rocky at the fair.
Nice.
And he's like going, say it right. And I'm saying it. It's like wrong. It's like Albarino. So we're like going through back and forth.
But you finally learned something.
I did. I taught you.
Yeah, well, at least I know this is downtown Paso.
I know, I said slow accidentally. My bad.
It's all good. So
we're just on the radio with Adam as well, which was kind of a good time.
Yeah, so, you guys always perform well. That's what she said.
Exactly.
Not me. Well, yeah.
No, yeah.
Yeah,
So bottom line, here's another tasting room downtown Paso. Good wine so far. Great location.
Super cool tasting room inside too. Very loungy, classy. Like,
and they allow dogs.
Totally bring your pups in.
What more could you ask for?
Yeah. Hey, stop yelling at us over there.
What is the matter with you people?
We're trying to blog.
All right, so we're out.
Blog.com.
And Up and Adam in the Morning, Q104.5. Was that it? Is that what you wanted to say?
I was actually going to ask one more quick question.
Okay, go ahead.
Do they allow cats?
Who cares? Who likes cats?
She owns a cat.
Oh, no, my bad. Why, though?
Here.
Yeah, why would you?
You don't mind. I mean, I know you're
all right, we're all good. So, Hoot Danny's out.